Every step we take is very important. We need to take one step at a time. Make haste slowly, but continue up a steady pace as evidence continues to compile that in this world we will either see disaster or love, gentle peacefulness. Either disaster or loving, gentle peacefulness. Those are the two options that we have in front of us. So we need to very steadily walk towards seeing loving, gentle peacefulness. Because if we don't do that, we will end up seeing catastrophe and disaster. It's a choice what we want to see, one or the other. We must be very careful not to think we can combine the two. There's most definitely, for those who want to see catastrophe and disaster, in other words, for those who don't want to see loving, peaceful, gentle kindness, they will get what they want. There's very strong evidence to indicate that there will be planetary catastrophes and disasters coming very, very soon, based upon the sun turning, being super energized by a galactic super wave of super hot magnetism and high energy particles, causing the sun to go shift into extremely high gear and expand into a red giant and basically melt the world by fire. So there will be catastrophe for those who want to see that. But for those who want to see safe love, peaceful gentleness, and invulnerability and safety, they will literally see that. Now, how is it possible that we can, both of those visions can be on the same Earth? I don't know how to explain that. It may not be possible. Because if the Earth is going to be burned by fire, melted down, surely there won't be any perceivers here to left at some point. So it could be very possible that the world will split in two, as it were, sort of like a cell divides into two. Okay, first there's a cell, and it gradually goes through a process of dividing, and then suddenly, pop, you know, there's two cells now. One cell will stand for seeing disaster, catastrophe, that's one world. The other cell stands for seeing peaceful, loving, gentle kindness, that's the second world. That is very possible. And we need to consider this step by step. We need to really keep on with the efforts we've been making. The evidence that there will be an option for disaster is getting very, very strong, adamant. I've received tremendous amount of evidence about this in many, many different ways, unexpected ways. So I say, wow, you know, that definitely is an option to see that. That will be an option to experience sacrifices. I call it planetary sacrifice. And I've done a great deal of videos and work on that. But the other flip side of that is seeing the real world, the world of perfect peace, the seamless, unconditional love. And it could literally be a planet will divide in two in different frequencies. And I believe we need to look at that. We need to look at it carefully. This is what's been suggested to me, that there will be sort of a separating out, like oil and water, depending on what one wants to see. Does one want to see fear and guilt, sacrifice, or does one want to see nothing but invulnerability and peace and calm and sinlessness? What world does one want to look upon? These are the questions that we are asking. I say, choose unconditional love, to look upon unconditional love. And we can literally get ourselves prepared for that. Should the situation eventuate where literally the choice is right in front of us. It's like we have two roads to go down. We've come to the crossroads and we're forking the road. And we can't keep going the way we've been going because the road now forks into two different worlds. One is the world of catastrophe. One is the world that is completely free of catastrophe. And we get to decide which world we are going to dwell in. A lot of preparation people have been making to dwell in one or the other. The preparations to dwell in the world of catastrophe, I've been observing those, monitoring them, looking at them, saying, wow, these people are really preparing. To my observational interpretation, they're preparing to participate in it for a global sacrifice. And on the other hand, I see a lot of us preparing to dwell in a world that is free from harm, free from all harm. And they're doing this in many ways. Maybe numerically, it's not as many. Who knows how that will shake out. But certainly, there are have been a great many boosts in this world for those who want to see a world where there's no harm, not possibility of any harm. And as I say, the one thing that's been difficult to understand is if this planet is indeed the sun is going to turn into a red giant, which I believe it will. I've had a lot of corroboration about this. Then certainly that is going to superheat the planet and everything upon the planet, make it inhabitable for the time being. That's certainly a lot of harm. So how can we remain on this planet and not see any harm is something that has perplexed me for a long time. But if we have the parting of the ways as the planet splits into two vibrational frequencies, so to speak, twins. We have twins. A twin planet. One a planet of catastrophe, another planet of no harm. Then I can see, yes, that would accommodate the situation. So let's not be surprised if this is what emerges. I have an intuitive feeling that we're on the right track here, that there's going to be twin planets. Each one will quickly become invisible to the other. And the preparations we are making, step at a time, step at a time, step at a time, are to get ready to shift into the harm-free planet, planet of unconditional love, harmlessness. We're getting step by step, we're moving in that direction. We're not trying to combat those who want to see a planet of catastrophe. That's their choice. They have every right to choose that. It's based on spiritual arrogance, the belief that we are capable of changing what we are, changing our identity. That's what it's really based on. This desire to change your identity so that we can become greater, become prime creator instead of the prime creator, that desire, that arrogance, has to be full of the experiencing of sacrifice. Has to. Meaning catastrophe, disaster, death, destruction. All of that, misery. It has to have that in order for us to forget what we are, or at least be in a state of forgetfulness of what we are, and to believe that it's possible the more we believe and have faith that things, that life can die, can be destroyed, can be harmed, the more we forget what we are, the fact that we cannot be harmed. We forget that. And then that enables us to pretend that we can be something else. We believe, we have faith and belief that we can be something else, and then we imagine that, yeah, we can be prime creator. The price we pay to play the game of 10 game of being Prime Creator, price we pay is disaster and catastrophe. But if we don't want to pay, don't want to play that game anymore, don't want to pretend anymore, the price we pay for that is we get to see a world that is free of all harm. That's the remedy for us. We get the prize, I guess you say, the prize we get for that is a wonderful prize. So, continue on with inquiry into unconditional love. And recognize the importance of this inquiry. It's all important for us right now as we move forward. Day by day, step by step, right now.